I will tell you, background checks. I've called many senators last night, many congressmen, and Jeff and Pam and everybody in this room. I can tell you, Curtis, they're into doing background checks that they wouldn't be thinking about maybe 2 weeks ago. We're going to do strong background checks. We're going to work on getting the age up to 21 instead of 18. We're getting rid of the bump stocks. And we're going to be focusing very strongly on mental health, because here's a case of mental health. Part of the problem is we used to have mental institutions, and I said this yesterday. We had a mental institution where you take a sicko like this guy. He was a sick guy. So many signs. And you'd bring him to a mental health institution. Those institutions are largely closed because communities didn't want them. Communities didn't want to spend the money for them. So you don't have any intermediate ground. You can't put him in jail because he hadn't done anything yet, but you know he's going to do something. So we're going to be talking seriously about opening mental health institutions again. In some cases, reopening. I can tell you in New York, the governors in New York did a very, very bad thing when they closed our mental institutions, so many of them. You have these people living on the streets. And I can say that in many cases throughout the country, they're very dangerous. They shouldn't be there. So we're going to be talking about mental institutions. And when you have some person like this, you can bring them into a mental institution. And they can see what they can do. But we got to get them out of our communities. So with that being said, I'd like to ask the very talented people around this table to just introduce themselves quickly and say a few words, and maybe we can start off with Pam Bondi.
Pam, thank you. I'm Pam Bondi.
We've been listening to President Trump talking to state and local officials about his thoughts on safety in general. He talked to not just about school safety, not just about gun safety, but went to something that he has talked about for almost 3 years now since he was a candidate, which is immigration and gangs and that kind of thing. I want to bring it back around the table to talk a little bit more about that. He, the president also, on the issue of guns, went to the notion of mental institutions, which is also something he said yesterday. The idea of mental health and making sure that people who have mental health issues don't get guns is something that is, I think, universally supported. Getting there is a whole other thing. But mental institutions, that's something different.
Yeah, I think this might have been some vamping on his part as sort of going to go
to... He did it twice.
...go to buzzwords. Yeah, but maybe. I don't know. I mean, look, I think there is certainly an idea on the right that... that a lot of things started to go badly when the mental institutions, 30, 40 years ago were all closed, that this has caused some sort of societal problem because, this has added to homeless and these sorts of things. But, I mean, there is also a distinction to be made between sort of mental health issues and the particular set of people who seem to be drawn to these mass shootings, mostly young men, although there's some young women isolated. I mean, it's a very particular and small subset that isn't really addressed by something sort of large, what he's talking about, institutionalizing. And there's also some questions about, well, how do you identify this before something happens?
And Phil, do you have any indication that there is going to be more of a kind of pulling along that the president will do to the people you cover every day in Congress than we've seen on other topics, and to do so in a successful way?
It's the question right now. In my mind, it's the most important thing that will dictate how this is going to go for the next couple of weeks. Are these just tweets and statements in photo sprays? Or are these things where, he talked about, I've called people, I've talked to people. Is he really going to put the work in to put this to the top of the agenda? Because I can tell you, top Republicans that I'm talking to on Capitol Hill right now are not saying that this is the top of the agenda. They're not saying, we're going to take this up next week in the Senate, and then we're going to move it to the House, and then we're going to do a bunch of other things. The president is going to not just have to push for this, but actively get out and almost force the hand of Capitol Hill Republicans if he wants something, anything, to actually move forward. As of now, we haven't gotten an indication whether or not that's going to be the case.
Very quickly, does he have the will, and does he have the muscle?
I think the only constant we know about this president is that he's an erratic trading partner, and we've seen that again and again and again in the past year. So it's hard to know if he's going to really put his back into this.
I think it's going to take somebody sort of big, a conservative senator that he listens to do it first. For Trump to follow.